local weather with the KX Storm Team.
Hey, Arthur, how is the weather?
Yeah, I don't know which one's Oakley and which one is Fenway. But man, they're both just cute, aren't they? That was so cool. All right, 71 degrees in Minot, the dew point at 35, winds out of the west, southwest at 18. 76 in Bismarck, winds at 14 miles an hour. Just a 9 mile an hour breeze in Williston, where it's 74 degrees. And boy, those are some dark clouds around Dickinson. 78 degrees, and the wind is calm in Dickinson. Area-wise, mostly 70s, a couple of 60s here. We've had some rain move through south of I-94, and that's certainly kept it from warming up too much. Fortunately, it has been very windy today, just a little breezy from place to place. And tomorrow is going to be even nicer than today because we should have a lot more sunshine tomorrow and even less wind. And it's not even windy. Here's a look at the latest drought monitor, and we could use some rain, especially in western North Dakota. I know there's places that don't need rain, but there are a lot of places that do. And the moderate drought has certainly expanded here recently. And we could get some rain this week. And the Storm Prediction Center has the area in yellow here as a slight risk for severe weather, which is a 2 on a scale of 5, which means there could be scattered as opposed to isolated, scattered severe thunderstorms, and we could be talking about some big hail in some of these storms, unfortunately. So we'll have to wait and see how this plays out this weekend. At this point, the severe weather threat is in South Dakota for the most part, a little bit of Montana there, and it looks like a sliver of Wyoming. But right now, everything is that's generating lightning is south of I-94. This other stuff you see up here is really light, and the atmosphere is so dry, may not even be reaching the ground, but you can see it kind of going through. It's gone through Selfridge, and it's kind of just continuing to track east. These are not big thunderstorms, but they are thunderstorms. So let's take a look at what's going on. By 7 o'clock tonight, you can see where the storms are likely going to be, and a fairly cloudy sky. And then as we go through the nighttime hours, many areas will have the sky clear out. And then looking at wind circulation here, looks like some kind of a little high pressure thing going on there. So Friday morning is going to be very nice. Throughout the day, should be terrific. Might have a few clouds coming in late in the afternoon. Shouldn't be windy tomorrow. By tomorrow night, the southwest might be getting a little bit breezy, and I think it could get flat out windy on Saturday. In fact, you can see when these isobars getting close, that means wind, and we might even have some kind of wind advisory on Saturday. But Saturday morning, there's the possibility of a couple of sprinkles, and it does not look like an all-day rain event. Now, for the wind, it looks like all day, but it does not look like all-day rain for Saturday, and that's a good thing, right, if you want to get outside for the weekend. But it is going to be windy, but Saturday night, it looks like we could have storms and severe weather work on its way on through, and then after they go by, it might even dry out for a little while. So Sunday morning, you may get up, and it may not be storming, but we're going to have a big flow. There's lots of lift here in the atmosphere, and there could be more rain showers and even possible severe weather Sunday afternoon as well. So the next 72 hours for Dickinson, we'll have temperatures kind of bounce around a little bit between the 70s and 80s, but Sunday's going to be hot and a little bit muggy. And then on Sunday for Williston, it's going to be about 85, kind of humid over the weekend as well. And yes, that chance of showers and thunderstorms, severe weather possible, actually both days. Forecast lows tonight will be in the 40s, and then daytime highs tomorrow are likely going to be in the 70s, so pretty decent weather. Here's a look at the next 7 days. After a beautiful day tomorrow, we have what could be off and on rain over the weekend and thunderstorms, and then next week things kind of settle down. But Lauren and Nicholas, it is going to be windy tomorrow, but it may not, or Saturday, but it may not rain all day.
Okay, Tom, thank you very much.